The pressure and contained risk-taking decision is determined by many factors. The first is the coach's philosophy. The coach may want you to play with more pressure or less pressure. Also, the game situation is something that needs to be considered, whether your team is leading or trailing. If you're trailing, you're definitely going to need to put more pressure on to get back into the game. Also, during the game, which zone are you checking in? If you're checking in your own zone or in front of the net, definitely there's going to be pressure. But in the offensive zone, there doesn't have to be as much pressure. The available number of supporting players is something that determines whether you pressure or contain. The opponent's strengths and weaknesses. For example, if the other team is very fast and scores when given a good opportunity, then you do not want to take too many risks, like pinching, for example, giving the other team an easy two-on-one. Also, then we should consider your own team's strengths and weaknesses. For example, if your team has great skating agility, then they can play with more pressure and a tighter gap control. If they're weaker at their skating, then they can't play with that much pressure. They have to play more of a contained situation. Pressure and contain terms. The coach could use these terms by saying pressure or patience, pressure or contain, pressure or restraint. The coach may say tight gap or loose gap, close gap or giving up ice. To conclude this video and preview where we are going in the next two videos, look at this chart. This chart lists these defensive positioning techniques with no contact given, leading to stick contact, and then if needed, body contact. So, no contact to stick contact to body contact. The third video will be stick contact, and the fourth video, body contact.